Welcome to Lesson 75. Someone saved my life tonight. We'll take a couple of liberties with this brilliant Elton John song, presented in 1975, by initially putting it in the key of G. Starting with two beats of G, one beat of C, and I'm choosing a C in second inversion, and then back to the G. The first part goes back and forth a little bit. Two beats of the G, one of C, back to the G, two of the C, the G again, and now we introduce the third chord, an F chord, and to the C. Let's do that together. Starting with the first verse. One, two, three, four. Let's do that first part again, starting from the top. One, two, three, four. The next part goes back and forth between an F and a G. I'll go ahead and move us up to root position for this here. Beginning with the word prima donna and the chord F. One, two, three, four. So you notice how we were going from the F in root position up to the G in root position, back to the F again, and the G. And it lands back on the C. So let's take it from the top. When I think of those East End lights, one, two, three, four. And then part of Elton John's piano genius is the way he uses major chords, in this case, moving to a minor chord. So the chords for the next section would be going from a C chord here to a C minor chord. And then a lovely A7. It's an A chord, 1, 3, 5, and then adding the 7, which is a G here. It then resolves it back to a C. And how nice to put in a C sharp diminished. Almost all the chords we use are major or minor, but in this case, we have a diminished chord, C sharp, E, and G, followed by the G chord, and it lands on the D. And that gets us entirely through the verse. So let's start where the C goes into the C minor. One, two, three, four. Let's take it again from the verse. We'll do the entire verse now. In this case, in the key of G. One, two, three, four. Then entering into the chorus, we start with a C chord, and moving down to a G chord in first inversion. And one thing to notice, the chord is C going to a G, but if you're playing the left-hand part of this, see how the first C chord begins with a C in the root. And then for the G chord, instead of playing the G down here in the root, we're playing the B in the root. So a C chord from the chorus, G over B, or a G with a B in the bass, which is the third in the bass, and then back down to an A minor in root position. And for right now, we'll take a little simplification just by going back up to that same chord, the G with the B in the bass. So the chorus begins, "And Someone Saved My Life Tonight, Sugar Bear." One, two, three, four. And a very similar thing happens on the next line. So again, the chorus from the top will be C. So it does three figures that are very similar with the C, G would be in the bass, A minor. And then when it gets to altar bound, there's a C chord, and then that wonderful C sharp diminished again to the G. Back to the C sharp diminished again. So we're going back and forth between a C-sharp diminished and a C. To the G. And then it lands on the C. G over B in the bass. A minor. And then a nice F chord. So we'll start with a chorus, "And Someone Saved My Life Tonight." One, two, three, four. Thank you for joining us for Lesson 75, this introduction to some of the chords that Elton John utilized for Someone Saved My Life Tonight.